just put it in a frame of an algorithm, and it is formalized to convert the steps, how we can convert the regular expression to NFA. Okay. So the algorithm is given by Mac now Town Yamada Thompson algorithm to convert the regular expression to an NFA. So a regular expression R over alphabet sigma is given to you as input, and output you have to generate is the NFN, which will accept the language given by R. Okay. So being by being the parsing R into its constituent sub-expression, the rule for the constructing an NFA consists of basis rule for handling sub-expressions with no operators and inductive rules for constructing larger NFAs for from the NFAs for the immediate sub-expression of a given expression. That means what? First, you have a basis rule. Basis rule will help you to generate small NFAs for small part of a given regular expression. So you have given a regular expression, say like a b whole star a b. So what can be a small part of this regular expression? You can just think it like this, that okay, I can write R1 star a b, where R1 equal to a or b, right? Then again I can just can have a smaller version of this, like R1 equal to R2 or R3, where R3 equal to only a and R sorry R2 equal to only a and R3 equal to only b. Now it is the very small regular expression, which is R2 and when R3. So we can easily construct a transition diagram for R2, which will look like this, right? And the same goes with R3. So now if we can break down our complex regular expression into small regular expression, and this smallest regular expression converted to NFA transitions, then again if we just merge them properly in proper way to represent the language which is given by this regular expression. So this adding up the small NFAs is called the inductive rules. Okay, so we have two things: basis rule and inductive rules. Now here is a simple basis. If you see for expression epsilon, so you have regular expression R, and which is only epsilon, that means empty string, right? So in NFA, what we can have, we can start from any state, give input epsilon, and we can reach the final state F, right? In the same way, for any sub expression, so we have A, where your R is equal to A. Now construct NFA for this. It can be that much simple. Start with this state I, give input A, and you reach to another state F, which is final state, because your regular expression R is only A here. Now induction or inductive rule, what is that? It is something that say you have two regular expression S and T, and for S you have this NS this NFA, and for T you have this NFA. Okay, this NFA is for S, this is for T. Now you have a regular expression R equal to S or T. So that means what? You can have an initial state from where you can take a lambda move or an epsilon move to S or NS, or you can come to NTU. Okay, so it is has become R. Okay, and you also get a final state, either it is coming from NS or it is coming from NT. So we have merged down. We have merged down to NF to pay, right? So it is just become a bigger NFA for a complex regular expression or which is representing a new language. And if you have concatenation, so this is the induction for union, okay, or if you have OR operation, okay, so STO is OR here, okay. But if you have concatenation, then you can do something like this. You just concatenate the another NFA at the end of the first NFA, and you get a bigger NFA which will represent R equal to S. So these are the rules. We will use these rules to convert regular expression to NFA. Now suppose you have a closure operation. You have you have a small regular expression given by S, and for S you have a NFA also. But if I say, okay, you have a regular expression which is R equal to S star, that means this S can repeat for n number of times, then as it is S star, you can see this can produce epsilon, right? One string in the language. So epsilon belongs LR. If that is the case, you don't need to enter into this given regular expression. You can just give X epsilon, and you have a start state, start state I, and you have a final state I, and you can just move from here to initial state to final state by giving epsilon. But it also means that it is a recursive language, and any repetition of S is acceptable. Then if there is a repetition of S, one or more than one times, then you enter into this NS, and you just get or add this transition so that S plus thing can be added here. Okay, so we have both the thing. We have epsilon move or epsilon string, and we have all the string given by S plus. Together it gives us S star. Okay, so if we have something R equal to S star, then our NFA will be looking like this, provided that you have the NFA which representing which is for NS. Okay, we have it. Okay, now what are the observation we have noticed here? That in R has at most twice as many state as there are operators and operands in R. Okay, this bound follows from the fact that each step of the algorithm creates at most two new states. Okay, so this algorithm creates at least two new state for every step. Okay, and in R has one start state and one accepting state. That is good thing. The accepting state has no outgoing transition. You can see this is a accepting state. There is no outgoing transition. Okay, start state has no incoming transition. Each state of NR other than the accepting state has either one outgoing transition or a symbol in sigma or set of alphabet, or two outgoing transition both on epsilon. So here if you see, two outgoing transition, both are epsilon. Okay, both are epsilon. This is one case, and what it say that the final state is does not have any outgoing, no, sorry, no outgoing path transition, right? And one outgoing transition on the sorry, on a symbol of sigma. So you can see here, wherever there is single outgoing path, here if you see, so single outgoing path we have for the state I for A, and definitely A belongs to sigma. So these are the things we can observe here. Now, how we do it in a formally step by step. First thing is that when you are being given a regular expression like this, you have to construct a parse tree for A. So if this is a regular expression, the parse tree can be constructed like this. Say first what we have, A or B. So we can simply do okay, A or B, but what we can do, we can take the smallest regular expression possible here. So we can do it like this. Okay, R1 equal to A we take, and R2 equal to B we take. Then we have to do A or B. Okay, so we take R3 equal to R2 or sorry, R1 or R2. That we do. Then we have AB whole star, but R3 is already giving this A or B. So we can have R4, which is R3 whole star. Okay. So here, instead, doing this, we have this bracket also, right? So we have to consider that. So R4 equal to in bracket R3, we can say. Then we have this bracket over star. So we can do R5 equal to R4 star. Okay? And then we can have R6, which is R6, which is only A, okay, and we can have R7, which is giving us concatenation of R5, concatenation of R5 and R6, okay. Then we can have R8, okay, R8 is this B, okay, and at the same time we can have R9, which just concatenate R7 and R8, R7 and R8, okay. The same way we can have R9, sorry, not R9, I already taken, so we can have R10, say, which is again only B, that last B, okay, and we can have R11, which will be concatenation of R9 and R10. Okay, now if I start generating the syntax tree for this given regular expression, it starts with what? The smallest part is R1 to A I get, and I also get R2 to B, then I have R3 here, which gives us, you know, R3, R1, or R2. Then I have R4. I have R4, which is in bracket R3, no problem. Then I have R5, which is R4 star. So see, R5 I have here, R4 and star. Okay, then I have R6, which is only A. So R6 is only A. Then I have R7, concatenation of R5 and R6. R7, concatenation R5 and R6. Then I have R8, which is only B. So R8 is giving only B. And I have R9, which is concatenation of R7 and R8. Okay. Then I have R10 here, R10, which is only B. And then I have R11 here, which is, you know, here R11, concatenation of R9 and R10. Now, I think it is clear to you that how this syntax tree is going to be generated. If you can generate this syntax tree, you can say that you are going to succeed to convert a regular expression into NFA using this algorithm. This syntax tree is very important. Okay. And what is the secret here? The secret is that every small part or every symbol will be a small regular expression. Okay, it became R1, this became R2, right? Then this together became R3, right? R3, and so on. So that you have to understand. Okay. Now, if you have this, then what you know, what steps we have to take next is for sub expression R1 equal to A, we can have a small NFA like this. We understand it. For R2 equal to B, we can have a small NFA like this. Right? From the basis, the first turn of basis rule, we can have these two things. Next, we have R3 equal to R1 or R2. So there was induction rule. For union, this R is basically represents union. I think you know it, right? So okay, so using this induction rule for union, we can just add a new start state from where, using epsilon move, we just move to the NFA of R1, or this is the NFA of R2, right? And also we add a final state. The final state of, you know, NFA of R1 using a epsilon move can come to this final state, or NFA of R2 can also can reach to this final state. Okay, so this is good enough. Now, next, what we had, step four, we had sub expression R4 equal to in bracket R3. So if you have this state, then there is nothing to do. It is same as R3. So you remain the same thing. All right. But what was our next step? Our next step was R5 equal to R3 whole star. So this is what we had, you know, NFA for R3. Now what is we are finding here, that R3 star, that means epsilon is a string in the language generated by R3. That means without giving anything, we can reach to what? Final state. So at the on a simple basis rule, we have learned if there is epsilon, we can have this move. Correct. So we have this here. Okay. Next, what we are finding that if we forget about epsilon, if it is R3 plus, now if you remove epsilon from this R star, then R3 plus remains in your hand. So for that, it is just repetition of same R3. So what we can do? We can add a loop or a transition from the final state of R3, this is here, to the initial state of R3. Okay, so we got an NFA for this R3 whole star. Okay, go to the next step. R6 we had there, I have shown you, which is equal to A. So by basis rule, we get this initial state to final state by giving only A. Next is concatenation is there. You can see here R7 equal to R5, concatenation R6. So concatenation I had already told you that it is what? We have the NFA for this is R5, and you can see this is NFA for R6. NFA for R6. So you understand what happened here? It is induction. What kind of induction? Concatenation. Okay. Next is step 8. For sub expression R8 equal to B. So again the same thing by basis rule. We can have this from the initial state to final state by giving input B. Okay. So and for R9, if you see, there is concatenation of R8 and R7. So for R8, we already have this NFA, and for R7, we have this NFA, right? So it is written in reverse basically. R7, R8. Okay. So again, this using induction rule, we get this. Then R10 gives us the same thing. We add it, concatenate it, and we get this. Okay. So finally, we get this, NFA M, which is, accepting the original regular expression which was given A or B cluster A B B. I think now it is clear why this NFA we was using was looking different from that one what we initially have done. That is on initial state, say one, it was taking A or B input. Then you give A another state, you go. You give B, you go to another state. You give another B, you go to the final state. Right. So this NFA and this NFA are equivalent. But when you are in compiler design, it is assumed that you know this algorithm. So whenever you will be given some regular expression like this, you have to construct NFA like this. Okay, then only you are going to get the marks. If you are going to generate this kind of NFA, you will not get enough marks. It can, you know, 50% or even 75% of the marks can be reduced. Okay.